Good afternoon. I'm Dr. Palani Swami, President of Annamalai West Extension Association. And also, I also represent some rural farmers, as I am also getting some trained agencies in the Goa Bhavani project. Now, I just combine both rural and urban water management. As far as the rural is concerned, I just bring to a concern that check dams are absolutely necessary wherever it is possible. Check dams. And as far as the resource utilization is concerned, it is very poor because rains are abundant. And we don't say that rains are anyway short. Rains are abundant, but we don't just use the resource in the better utility value. Again, when we come to desiltation of tanks and beds, now the government has got a very bad policy contrast. Now they have got the mining department to control the sand mining. But the same mining department controls the desilting or deepening of the tanks and beds, tanks and beds. So both are different. One is for commercial purpose, one is for purpose for utilities purpose. So there is absolutely necessity for deepening of the lakes and ponds. Now they have to definitely, the government has to definitely take a different view as far as the mining is concerned. It's a different mining, it's a different mining. So I request the August body to take it to the government that mining should not be common for lake deepening as well as for sand mining. And the desilting of canals, it is totally absent. I have had a lot of problems with my own land. And the desilting, they don't desilt. There are a lot of abundance of trees and both brand, both ones. And they just prevent the water flow. And the water flow is not a natural thing. And wherever the water flow is prevented, it gets into flood into the neighboring villages. So waterways should be very clear. The other issue is, now, as far as the agriculture is concerned, it is also totally in bad shape. Now, we were talking about quantity. The quality of the water also differs. Now, when we go deep beyond 500 feet, it is totally salinity. We get water, but only saline water. Now, it has changed the agriculture pattern itself. Totally, whenever we were able to cultivate paddy, we were not able to cultivate paddy. Whenever you want to cultivate coconut, the coconut plants are not giving absolute production. Even my sorghum plant has just withered because of saline water. So this agriculture pattern itself is changing because of the quality of water. And in this pattern, so the agriculture department should intervene and they say what type of plant you should have for this salinity or for the quantity that is available. So they have to have certain guidelines. Now agriculture department is totally sleeping. They don't do any work as far as the villages are concerned. So many agriculture officers are there, agriculture assistant officers are there. They are not giving any point of concrete suggestions to the farmers. Now, when we come to urban water management, now you are totally aware that the stormwater drain, integrated stormwater drain project is going on in Chennai City. It's a 1,000 crore project funded by World Bank and also controlled by the World Bank office from New Delhi, not from Chennai. So, you would have seen the stormwater construction pattern. Now they have got a width of 0.9 to 1.9 and a depth of about 3 to 3 feet or 5 feet. Now the depth is being fully concretized. The bottom is concretized. Sides are concretized. Top is concretized. Only there are catch pits for flow of water inside the stormwater drain. Now, where is the point of improving the groundwater when the entire water is getting runoff to the poor or to the development. So the total design itself is very bad. And when I talk with these project management consultants or some other people in the World Bank, they say for every 30 feet we are giving this rainwater harvest catch points. But it is not sufficient. Every 30 meters, they provide catch points for the rainwater harvest just for a depth of 10 feet and a die of 3 feet. Now, is it enough to just harvest the entire water that is being given by the monsoon? So, the entire water is getting run off with massive storm of rain construction that is going on in the Chennai city. So I wish that they should have something to absorb the ground, absorb the rainwater into the ground, so that the groundwater level comes up. So thousands of crores are getting wasted, but we talk about water conservation, we talk about the conservation of water and enriching the water management or lifting the soil, groundwater level in the city. So these are the certain points I want to bring into the kind attention of the people. The resource is there. And again, somebody was telling about the growing of eucalyptus trees, Madai Vembu, and also this prosopis that is very different. Definitely, they are affecting the rural water level. This Madai Vembu is also It is also for the paper manufacture, that is paper program. It is also goes very deep inside the soil, and they also absorb water. So nearby fields where the paddy is cultivated or banana is cultivated, they are getting just a very very scanty amount of water for their purposes. Eucalyptus plains, eucalyptus plains cultivate for now, because the governments are giving robust money. And this, as the High Court in right away suggested yesterday, that if Moon wants to go on bail, he has to remove at least 100 prosopis trees. So that is a good thoughts that have prevailed in the among the judiciary. And I think So these are the certain observations I want to have. And the main thing is, I want to take this body to just impress upon the integrated water system and rain authorities that they should have enough rainwater harvest. Enough rainwater harvest. Just inside the floor of the Thank you.